is homophone. So it's actually quite interesting. In that lesson, so we'll talk about words that you will write differently, but then phonetically you will pronounce them the same way, and of course they will have different meanings. Okay, so let's start now, and the first one is un air. Okay, we'll make this little link between the two, un air. Okay, and here you've got the translation in English. And then you've got une air. Okay, so you can see that you write it differently, but then clearly phonetically it's the same, une air. And this is the translation in English. Une amende. Une amende. And that's what it means. And then une amende. So here you can see that the only difference is here you've got a, and here you've got a. Okay? So amende, amende. And the meaning is fine. We're talking here about the nice little gift you will get if you break the law. Une amende. Une encre. Une encre. And then feminine as well, une encre. Okay, so you can see here that the only difference is a here and then a here. Okay, so une encre and une encre, it's the same. Un bar. Un bar. And then une bar. Okay, so you can hear that it's exactly the same way to that you pronounce, but then you've got R, R, and then E. Okay, une bar. Okay, so in that case, it's this adjective, bon, and the meaning is good in English. Okay, bon, all right. And here we've got substantive, un bon. Un bon. Un bout. Remember, final T not pronounced. Un bout. Une bout. Okay, so here the only difference between the two is here you get T at the end and here you get E at the end. Une bout. Un but. Un but. Une but. Une but. Un sang. Okay, remember this G here doesn't exist, so un sang. And then here we've got this sang. Quite useful because it means without, sans. And we've got a third one, sans, written like that, and it's 100. Okay, so un sans, sans, sans. Un champ, un champ, un champ. Un champ. So here it's quite tricky because if you look carefully, well, of course you pronounce them the same way because that's the topic of this video, but then masculine in both cases. So un champ, un champ. Un col. Un col. Une colle. Une colle. The lysomophone, because actually I was thinking about doing four videos concerning this topic. So remember, when we're talking about lysomophone, we're talking about all these words that we have in French that you will write differently but then pronounce the same way, and of course the meanings will be different. So that's the reason why it's quite important to take a few minutes to try to see them and try to avoid any mistakes. Okay? Alright, so we'll start now. And the first one is un compte. Un compte. And here you will have the translation. Un conte. So exactly the same pronunciation, but then of course the meaning is different. Un conte. Un coup. And then un coup. Alright, so you can see that you get this final B here, but then you don't pronounce it. And last, un coup. Okay, remember, accent circonflex, you don't pronounce it. Final T, same thing, you don't pronounce it. Okay, so un coup, and then un coup, the same pronunciation. Une cour. And then we've got the adjective cour. And after that, un cours. And then un cours. Alright, so you can see that here you get the feminine, une cour, then you get the adjective cours, un cours, un cours. Un cuir. And the verb cuir. Okay, so un cuir and then cuir. Une date. Une date. So it's quite interesting because in English it's written the same way. Okay, so in that case we're talking about the fruit. So une date. Okay, and here une date. So 31 janvier, for instance. Une date. Okay. Une eau. And then the adjective eau. Okay, une eau, eau. Une fin. And then une fin. Okay, so phonetically the same. Un fil. Une file. Okay, so don't try to, well, don't mix it with une fille, okay, because you get the double L, but in that case you get only one, so une file, okay? Un fil, une file. Lait. Un lait. Okay, so the only difference is final thing here, D, you don't pronounce it, T, you don't pronounce it, so phonetically you only have this le. Une mer. Une mer. Un mer. Alright, so mer, mer, mer. Right, in both cases. Here you've got the feminine form and then here it's masculine. Of course, it could be feminine as well because mère can be ladies as well. Les homophones, so remember, we write them differently, we pronounce them the same way, and they have different meanings. Okay, so that's the thing. It is the third video, so the next one will be the last one covering this topic. Okay, so let's start now. Un maître, and so you will have the translation here. Un mètre, and then un mètre as well. Okay, so un mètre and un mètre, same pronunciation. Un mois, and then moi, me. Okay, so un mois and moi. Un mur. And the adjective mur. Okay, so un mur and mur. Un nez. Nez. Okay, so un nez and nez. Un nom. Nom. Un nom, non. Un pain. Un pain. Right? Un pain. Un pain. Un père. Une paire. Père. Okay, so in that case, we're talking about the numbers. Alright, so père. So here, un père, une paire, père. Une patte. Une patte. Okay, une patte, une patte. Une paume. Une pomme. Okay, so you can see that I pronounce them a little bit, well, a little bit differently, but then we'll be careful that in many, many cases people will pronounce them the same way, okay, because in that case normally it should be a bit lower, pomme, and then here more open, so pomme, okay. Une pause. Une pause. Okay, so une pause, une pause. Les homophones, so it's the fourth video covering this topic. Remember, les homophones, we're talking about words that are pronounced the same way but written differently, and of course the meaning is different. Okay, so we'll see 10 of them in this video. So let's start with the first one. Une peau. And here you have the meaning in English. Une peau. Un pot. Okay, so une peau, un pot. Un point. Un point. Alright, so you can see that here the only difference is the final letter, okay, but then they are pronounced the same way and both of them are masculine. Un point, un point. Un port. Un port. Okay, exactly the same thing here. Only the last letter is different. You don't pronounce it, and then both of them are masculine. Un port. Un prêt. 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 Okay, so it's quite interesting here. So you get un prêt written like that. So in that case, it's a substantive. So word, noun, and that's the meaning. Then you get prêt like that, so final S, but then of course you don't pronounce it. And here, prêt, so the adjective, okay. Une roue. Roue. Alright, so une roue, and then roue. Salle. Une salle. Okay, so even if you get the double L here, it will be still the same pronunciation as this one. So, salle, une salle. So in that case, it's here, it's an adjective. Un seau. Un seau. Okay, so un seau, and then the same way, un seau. Sûr. Sûr. Okay, even if you get this accent circumflexe, you don't pronounce it, so you get the same pronunciation, sûr and sûr. Une tente. Une tente. Okay, so it's exactly the same pronunciation, even if you get a here, here, and a here. Okay, and both of them are feminine. Une tente. Un toit. Toit. Okay, so in that case, we're talking about moi, toi, lui, elle. So we saw that a long time ago. Okay, and then both of them are pronounced like toi. Un toit, toi. Le préfixe il, so il. When we're talking about préfixe, normally we're talking about, well, letters, a group of letters that you will put in front of existing words. And by adding these letters or group of letters, you will change the meaning or the original meaning of the word. Okay, and that will be the case with this préfixe il. Okay, so let's see. And so normally if we're talking about this il prefix, then it will mean privé de sans. Okay, and this is actually what it means in English, so without or then, well, less. Okay, so that will be the meaning of this il prefix. Let's see three examples. So the first one here, légitime, okay, so légitime. And then if you want to express, well, the without concept, then you will add this prefix il at the beginning, and then after that you continue with your original word légitime, and now you get illégitime. Okay, illégitime, légitime, illégitime. Second example, lisible, okay, lisible, and then same idea, you just add this il in front, and then you get illisible, illisible, and the last one, légal, okay, légal, exactly the same concept. You just add this il in front of légal and you get illégal. Okay, so of course you understood that we add this il here because the original word is starting with l. Okay, so that's the reason why you will have this e and then l. All right, so légal, illégal. Le préfixe im. Okay, so when we're talking about prefix, we're talking about letters that you will add at the beginning of existing words, and by adding these letters you will modify the meaning of the word. Okay, so let's see now. And in this lesson, well, by adding this im at the beginning of existing words, in most of the cases they will start with p. Okay, just for information, by adding this im you will modify the meaning, and it will mean privé de or sans. Okay, that is the result that you will get by adding this im. Okay, so let's see now a few examples. The first one is père. Okay, so the meaning is even, and then I just put some numbers to make it clear that we're talking about numbers. So 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay, so père. And then if you want to express the without, so you will use this impair, impair. So you put im, and then after that the rest, impair. Okay. Pardonnable, pardonnable. Same rule, same way of working. Im in front, impardonnable, impardonnable. Parfait, parfait, exactly the same, imparfait, imparfait. Pensable, pensable, and then it goes all the time the same way, impensable, Impensable. Poli. Poli. Impoli. Impoli. Possible. Possible. Impossible. Impossible. Précis. Précis. Imprécis. So you can see that it's all the time the same technique, so you just add this EM in front. Imprécis. Probable. Probable. Improbable. Improbable. Prudent. Prudent. Imprudent. Imprudent. Be le préfixe IN. Okay, so remember, when we're talking about préfixe, we just were talking about letters that you will put in front of existing words, and by adding these letters, you will modify the original meaning of the word. Okay, so in that case, this IN préfixe will mean privé de or sans. Okay, privé de sans. And this EN will be used when the original word is starting with a vowel or H plus une voyelle. Okay, so let's see a few examples now. And the first one is acceptable. Okay, acceptable. You will have the translation here in English, and it's not that difficult in that case. And if you want to express this privé de or sans, okay, without or less, then you will add this EN as we saw first at the beginning of your word, then you will just add your word and you get inacceptable. Okay, acceptable, inacceptable. Achevé, inachevé. Okay, achevé. Inachevé. Admissible. Inadmissible. Admissible. Inadmissible. Animé. Inanimé. Animé. Inanimé. Attendu. Inattendu. Attendu. Inattendu. Imaginable. Inimaginable. Imaginable. Inimaginable. Oubliable, inoubliable, oubliable, inoubliable, utile, inutile, utile, inutile. Le préfixe IR, and the good news is that it will be the last video for this chapter of préfixe. Okay, so if you remember, when we're talking about préfixe, actually we're talking about letters, like in that case IR, that you will add at the beginning of an existing word, and by adding these letters you will modify the meaning or the original meaning of the word. Okay, and in that case, when you will put this IR, and you will see that we're talking about words that will start with R, okay? But then you will modify the meaning, and the meaning will be privé de or sans. Okay, privé de or sans. So let's check three examples. And the first one is réel. Okay, réel. And then, as I said, you just add this IR, and then after that you put your réel again, and you will get irréel. Irréel, okay? Réel, and then irréel. Régulier, so as I said, remember, they start with R all the time. Régulier, and then exactly the same technique. IR, and after that you put it back, irrégulier, okay? Régulier, then irrégulier. And the last one, résistible, résistible, and exactly the same way, IR, and you put it back, irrésistible, irrésistible, so résistible, irrésistible. Le suffixe isé, I-S-E-R, okay? So after having doing some videos regarding les préfixes, now we'll try to see a little bit what we call les suffixes, okay? So les suffixes, actually we're talking about these letters that you can put or you can add at the end of existing words, and by adding these letters you will modify it or you will change the meaning, or in that case we will change adjectives into verbs. Okay, so that's the whole idea of this video, and here we'll only focus on the adjectives that will end with al, okay, al, and then, well, as we saw, we will just add at the end of these adjectives this iser just to make a verb. Okay, so let's see a few examples now. And the first one is banal. Okay, so here is the meaning in English. Okay, so if we want to make a verb out of this adjective, then we only need to, as I say, put this ESER at the end, and then you will get banalisé. Banalisé. Okay, so adjective banal, verb banaliser. Brutal, and then we will get brutalisé. Okay, brutal, and then you just add this I-S-E-R at the end, and you'll get brutalisé. Central. Centralisé. Okay, exactly the same way. Central, and then the verb centralisé. Égal, égalisé. Égal, égalisé. Général. Généralisé. Général. Généralisé. Légal. Légalisé. Légal. Légalisé. National. Nationalisé. National. Nationalisé. Le suffixe E-M-E-N-T, ement, okay? And the idea is to, well, see how we can clearly come from a verb and to make from that verb a noun, okay? And so the idea is we'll see that if your verb is ending with er, okay, so that's what we'll see in this video, but of course it doesn't, as usual when we learn French, it doesn't concern all the verbs ending with er, okay, but actually the verbs that we'll see in this lesson will work with that concept. So you will actually need to take away this er ending and you will replace it with the suffix, so this thing e-m-e-n-t, okay, to get the noun. And you've got to keep in mind that the noun must express the action, okay, because you can have many nouns or many substantives, as we say, that will express different things, okay, but in that case, when you're going from the verb to this substantive, so this noun, it must express the action, okay? So let's see a few examples now. The first one, so amuser, okay, so you will have here the translation in English, okay? So, well, if we just respect the rule, so we take away this er, and then we will modify, and we will put this suffix e-m-e-n-t instead, and we will get this un amusement, okay? So, amuser, un amusement. Changer, un changement. Changer, un changement. Commencer, un commencement. Commencer, un commencement. Se comporter, un comportement. Se comporter, un comportement. Développer, un développement. Développer, un développement. Gouverner, un gouvernement. Gouverner, un gouvernement. Grouper, un groupement. Grouper, un groupement. Rassembler, un rassemblement. Rassembler, un rassemblement. Traiter, un traitement. Traiter, un traitement. Le suffixe -ement, okay? And the idea is to see how we could make nouns or substantives if we're starting from the verbs, okay? So let's see. The idea is that we're talking here about the verbs that will belong to the second group of verbs, so ending in er, okay? And well, the rule or the way to make them is that we'll take away this er, so the ending of the verb, and we'll replace it with the le suffix -ement, so E-S-S-E-M-E-N-T. Okay, so that's the rule. And then the only thing that we should keep in mind, because of course if we're talking about making substantives based on verbs, it's possible to have different type of substantives, but in that case the substantive, so the noun, must express the action, okay? And that's the only thing that you should keep in mind. Okay, so let's see a few examples now. The first one, élargir, and so you can see here the translation in English, un élargissement. Okay, so you can see that as we saw, you just need to take away this er from the verb and then you replace it with the issement, okay, and then you get the un élargissement. Okay, so élargir, un élargissement. Ralentir, un ralentissement. Ralentir, un ralentissement. rajeunir, un rajeunissement. Rajeunir, un rajeunissement. Vieillir, un vieillissement. Vieillir, un vieillissement. Okay, so it will be the first, here you can see, the first video covering this E-O-N words that are the same in English and in French. Okay, and so the rule is that, of course, E-O-N, so you will have the same words in English and in French if the word exist in French, and that's the first thing. And then remember that in some cases, so E will become E in French, so we'll put the accent, and then in some cases Z, so la lettre Z will become la lettre S. Okay, all right, I didn't put the article, but then in most of the cases they are feminine. Okay, so let's start now. Abdication, ablution, abnégation, abolition, abomination, abrogation, absorption, abstention, abstraction, accélération, accentuation, acceptation, accession, acclamation, accommodation, accréditation, accumulation, accusation, acidification, acquisition, action, activation, adaptation, addiction, addition, adhésion, administration, admiration, admission, adoption, adoration, adulation, aération, affectation, affection, affiliation, affirmation, agglomération, aggravation, agression, agitation, aliénation, alimentation, allégation, allocation, allocution, allusion, alphabétisation, altération, altercation. These topic identical words in English and in French, okay? And in that video, we'll cover the E-O-N, so we're talking about the endings here, words, okay? But then keep in mind that all the E-O-N words in English won't be the same in French, okay? So the first thing that you get to remember is that if it exists in French, then it will be the same, and normally the meaning will be the same. Keep in mind as well that in some cases we'll have some differences in the writing, okay? So could become A and then Z could become S, okay? But then let's see now. So it's the second part of the list. If you're interested by this thing, then remember that there was a previous video that covered 50 words. In that video we'll cover still 50 words, and then the, if I remember correctly, the total amount is 500. Okay, so ambition, amélioration, amplification, amputation, animation, annexion, annotation, annulation, anticipation, apparition, appellation, application, appréciation, appréhension, approbation, appropriation, approximation, articulation, ascension, aspiration, assignation, assimilation, association, attention, atténuation, attestation, attraction, attribution, audition, augmentation, auscultation, aviation, bénédiction, bureaucratisation, calcification, calcination, calibration, canalisation, cannibalisation, capitalisation, célébration, cessation, cicatrisation, circulation, citation, civilisation, clarification, classification, coalition, cohabitation. Series of videos that we started earlier, and the topic is identical words in English and in French, and in that case we'll cover the words that will end with E-O-N. So the first rule that you've got to keep in mind is that if it exists in French, it will be the same, okay, but it's not all the time the case. Alright, and then the second thing that you should remember is that in some cases we'll write them a little bit differently, so you can see that in French will be A in some cases, and then Z here in some cases will become S. Okay, so let's see, and the list continues. Cohésion, collaboration, collation, collection, collision, collocation, collusion, colonisation, coloration, combustion, commémoration, commercialisation, commission, communication, communion, compassion, compensation, compétition, compilation, complication, composition, compréhension, compression, concentration, conception, conclusion, condition, confection, confédération, confession, configuration, confirmation, confrontation, confusion, connotation, consécration, conservation, considération, conspiration, consternation, construction, contagion, contamination, contemplation, contestation, continuation, contorsion, contraception, contraction, contradiction. Theme, identical words in English and in French, and we'll especially focus on this video and the previous and the following videos on the words that will end with E O N, okay? And then keep in mind that the first rule, it must exist in French. All E O N words in English, they don't exist in French, okay? So, well, that's the first thing. And then remember that in some cases, we'll write them a little bit differently. Okay, so that's the thing. And the list continues. Contravention. Contribution. Contusion. Convention. Conversation. Conversion. Conviction. Convocation. Coopération. Coordination. Coproduction. Corrosion. Corruption. Création. Crémation. Criminalisation. Sorry, it's a difficult one. So again, criminalisation. Cultivation. Cumulation. Désactivation. Déception. Décision. Déclaration. Décolonisation. Décomposition. Décoration. Déduction. Définition. Déformation. Dégradation. Dégustation. Délation. Délectation. Délégation. Délibération. Démission. Démobilisation. Démocratisation. Démodulation. Démolition. Démonétisation. Démonstration. Dénationalisation. Dénaturalisation. Dénigration. Dénomination. Dépigmentation. Déportation. Déposition. Dépression. Dérision. Identical words in English and French, and we'll only focus on the E-O-N, so the words that will end with E-O-N in English, and that will be the same in French, but then keep in mind that, of course, it must exist in French, because it's not the case for all the words in E-O-N. So be careful. That's the reason why I wanted to make this huge list, but then after that you'll know which one exists in French. And then remember that in some cases the word will a little bit change, so you get the example here. Will become A, and then Z will become S. Okay. Description. Désignation. Désolation. Déstabilisation. Destination. Destruction. Détection. Détention. Détérioration. Détermination. Détonation. Dévaluation. Dévastation. Déviation. Diction. Diffusion. Digestion. Dilatation. Dimension. Diminution. Direction. Discrimination. Discussion. Disposition. Disqualification. Dissociation. Distinction. Distribution. Diversification. Diversion. Divination. Division. Documentation. Domiciliation. Domination. Donation. Dotation. Dramatisation. Duplication. ébullition, éclosion, édification, édition, éducation, élaboration, électrocution, élévation, élimination, élocution, élucidation. Identical words in English and French, and we'll concentrate on the words ending with E-O-N, okay? And then remember that the main thing with this E-O-N words in English that it must exist, of course, in French, because it's not the case for all the E-O-N words in English. And then in some cases we'll have some modifications in the writing in French, okay? So let's continue with 50 new words. Émancipation, émission, émotion, épilation, équation, équitation, érosion, éruption, estimation, évacuation, évaluation, évaporation, évasion, évolution, exaltation, exaspération, exception, exclamation, exclusion, excursion, expansion, expatriation, expédition, expiration, explication, exploitation, exploration, explosion, exposition, expression, expulsion, extension, externalisation, extinction, extraction, extrapolation, fabrication, fascination, fédération, fiction, fixation, formation, formulation, fraction, fragmentation, frustration, fusion, généralisation, génération, glaciation. Identical words in English and French, and we'll only focus in this video on the words in English that will end with E-O-N, because in many cases they will be exactly the same in French, but you should keep in mind that it's not all the time true. So first, well, the word must exist in French because it's not, you know, the case all the time, okay? And then the second thing that you should keep in mind, in some cases, well, the writing of these words will change a little bit, okay? Gratification, gravitation, habitation, hésitation, hibernation, hospitalisation, humidification, humiliation, idéalisation, identification, illumination, illusion, illustration, imagination, imitation, immersion, immigration, immobilisation, immunisation, imperfection, implantation, implication, implosion, imposition, impression, improvisation, impulsion, inaction, inactivation, inattention, inauguration, incarnation, incinération, incitation, incompréhension, incorporation, incrustation, incubation, indécision, indexation, indication, indigestion, indignation, indiscrétion, indisposition, infection, inflation, information, infraction, infusion. Identical words in English and French, and in this video we'll only focus still on the words in English that will end with E-O-N, and that will be the same in French. So in some cases persons tend to say that all the English words ending with E-O-N are exactly the same in French, and I've been working on that at least quite much, and I can tell you that unfortunately that's not the truth. So the first thing that you should keep in mind, that it will be the same if it does exist in French, and it's not the case all the time. And then the second thing that you should keep in mind, that in some cases the writing of the words will change a little bit. Okay, let's start now. Injection, innovation, inscription, insertion, insolation, inspection, inspiration, installation, instauration, institution, instruction, intégration, intention, interception, interdiction, internationalisation, interpellation, interprétation, intervention, intimidation, intoxication, introduction, invasion, invention, investigation, invocation, irrigation, isolation, juxtaposition, légalisation, légion, législation, lésion, libéralisation, libération, limitation, location, locomotion, locution, lotion, malédiction, malformation, malnutrition, malversation, manifestation, manipulation, mention, migration, militarisation, million. And I just realized that I've been making a mistake here. It should be a 3 instead of 2, okay? Sorry, I won't make this video again only for these 2 little mistakes, okay? Identical words in English and French, and we'll especially focus on the words in English that will end with E-O-N, okay? Keep in mind that the first thing that you should remember is that it must exist in French, because all these E-O-N words in English won't exist in French. And then the second thing that you should keep in mind, in some cases the writing will change a little bit. Let's start. Mobilisation, modération, modernisation, modification, motivation, munition, mutation, mystification, narration, natation, nation, nationalisation, naturalisation, navigation, négation, nomination, notion, objection, obligation, observation, occasion, opération, opinion, opposition, optimisation, option, orchestration, organisation, orientation, pacification, palpitation, partition, passion, pension, perception, percussion, perfection, perforation, perfusion, permission, persécution, persuasion, perturbation, pétition, plantation, pollution, population, portion, position, possession. Identical words in English and French, and especially the words that will end with E-O-N. Keep in mind that not all the words in English that will end with E-O-N exist in French, so it must exist in French, of course, to be used in this language. And then the second thing that you should keep in mind, in some cases, the writing will change a little bit. Okay, so let's continue. Potion, précaution, précipitation, précision, prédiction, préméditation, prémonition, préoccupation, préparation, préposition, présentation, prévention, prévision, privatisation, procuration, production, profession, profusion, prohibition, projection, prolongation, promotion, proportion, proposition, propulsion, protection, protestation, provision, provocation, publication, pulsion, pulvérisation, punition, purification, qualification, ration, rationalisation, réaction, réactivation, réalisation, réclamation, récupération, rédaction, redécoration, redéfinition, rédemption, redirection, réduction, réévaluation, reformation. Identical words in English and French, and we were talking about the words in English that will end with E-O-N, okay? And that will be the same, but if they exist in French, because all the English words ending with E-O-N, well, they don't all exist in French. So that's the first thing that you should keep in mind. And then the second thing is that in some cases, we will write in French these words a little bit differently. So few cases like here, would become A, and then Z would become S, okay? So let's continue. Région, régression, relation, relaxation, religion, rénovation, réorientation, réparation, répartition, répétition, reproduction, répulsion, réputation, résolution, respiration, restitution, restauration, restriction, réunification, réunion, révélation, révision, révolution, rotation, salutation, sanction, saturation, sécession, section, séduction, sélection, sensation, séparation, signalisation, signification, simulation, situation, spécialisation, spécification, spéculation, stabilisation, station, stimulation, soumission, succession, suffocation, suggestion, supervision, suppression, synchronisation, télévision, tension, torsion, traction, tradition, transaction, transcription, transformation, transition, transpiration, transportation, union, urbanisation, utilisation, vaccination, valorisation, vaporisation, variation, végétation, version, vibration, victimisation, violation, vision, vocation. Le corps humain, donc le vocabulaire concernant le corps humain. Le tube digestif. Le tube digestif. L'articulation. L'articulation. La bouche. La bouche. Le bras. Le bras. La cage thoracique. La cage thoracique. Le cerveau. Le cerveau. Les cheveux. Les cheveux. La cheville. La cheville. La clavicule. La clavicule. Le cœur. Le cœur. La colonne cervicale. La colonne cervicale. La colonne dorsale. La colonne dorsale. La colonne vertébrale. La colonne vertébrale. La côte. La côte. Le cou. Le cou. Le coude. Le coude. Le crâne. Le crâne. La cuisse. La cuisse. La dent. La dent. Le doigt. Le doigt. Le dos. Le dos. L'épaule. L'épaule. L'estomac. L'estomac. Le foie. Le foie. Le front. Le front. Le genou. Le genou. L'intestin. L'intestin. La jambe. La jambe. La joue. La joue. La lèvre. La lèvre. La mâchoire. La mâchoire. La main. La main. Le membre. Le membre. Le menton. Le menton. Le muscle. Le muscle. Le nerf. Le nerf. Le nez. Le nez. La nuque. La nuque. L'œil. L'œil. L'ongle. L'ongle. L'oreille. L'oreille. L'orteil. L'orteil. L'os. L'os. La paume de la main. La paume de la main. La phalange. La phalange. Le pied. Le pied. La plante du pied. La plante du pied. Le poignet. Le poignet. Le poing. Le poing. Le pouce. Le pouce. Le pouls. Le pouls. Le poumon. Le poumon. Le rein. Le rein. Le sang. Le sang. Le talon. Le talon. La tempe. La tempe. La tête. La tête. Le thorax. Le thorax. Le tibia. Le tibia. Oops, I made a mistake here. It should be masculine. Sorry about that. Le ventre. Le ventre. Les abrégements de mots. And we'll only focus in this video on les abrégements de mots, but well, the words that will end with O or the sound of O. Okay? So let's start now. Un adolescent. Un adolescent. Un adolescent. Okay? And then in most of the cases when people will speak, they will use un ado. Un ado. Okay, so un adolescent will become un ado. Un apéritif. Un apéritif will become un apéro. Un apéro. Okay, so un apéritif. Un apéro. Une décoration. Une décoration. And it will become une déco. Une déco. Okay, so une décoration. Une déco. Une démonstration. Une démonstration will become une démo. Une démo. Une démonstration. Une démo. Un dictionnaire. Un dictionnaire will become un dico. Okay? Un dico. So one more time. Un dictionnaire. Un dico. Une exposition. Une exposition will become une expo. Une expo. un hebdomadaire, so in that case we're talking about the magazine, un hebdomadaire will become un hebdo, okay? Un hebdo. So one more time, un hebdomadaire, un hebdo. Un intellectuel will become un intello, okay? One more time, un intello. Un laboratoire will become un labo, personnel. Personnel will become perso. Perso. Okay, one more time. Personnel. Perso. Un professionnel will become un pro. Un pro. Okay, so un professionnel, un pro. Un propriétaire will become un proprio, okay, so un proprio. Un restaurant will become un resto, okay, so you can see that here you've got another way of writing it, okay, but then, well, phonetically it's exactly the same, so un resto, okay, so whether with O or then with AU, but then it's resto, resto, the same way, okay, so un restaurant, un resto. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent, this is Unité 12, Leçon C. And in this lesson, we will see les préfixes de verbes. So remember these little letters that you can put at the beginning of existing words, or in that case, it will be verbs. And by adding these little letters, you will modify the original meaning of the word. And in this lesson, we'll work on le préfixe de. Okay, and you'll see because, well, quite often I've been having some students that asked me, how do you translate in French, or is there a way to make this un that exists in English? So like do, undo, okay? And then the answer is yes. Actually, we've got this prefix de, okay? So it will actually be, well, the same. I mean, the use will be the same as in English, this un, or as well there is this this for some verbs. So it will be exactly the same thing, okay? We've got this de, okay? Keep in mind that we will see in the next lesson, so it will be unit 12, lesson D, we've got the option of de accent aigu s, and we will see that so in the next lesson, but in this lesson we'll only focus on the d. Okay, so let's take an example now. We've got brancher, okay, and then débrancher, all right? So it's actually quite easy. You just put this d in front of the verb and then brancher. Brancher, débrancher. Centraliser, décentraliser. Okay, centraliser, and then it will become décentraliser. Charger, décharger. Okay, so charger and then décharger. Coiffer, décoiffer. Alright, so coiffer, and then you put this D and after the verb décoiffer. Coller, décoller. Okay, so coller, and then it will become décoller. Commander will become décommander. Okay, so commander will become décommander. Composer, Décomposer. All right, so composer will become décomposer. Conseiller will become déconseiller. All right, so conseiller, déconseiller. Couvrir will become découvrir. Okay, so couvrir, découvrir. Faire will become défaire. Okay, so faire, défaire. Former, déformer. All right, so former, déformer. Placer will become déplacer. Placer, déplacer. Plaire, déplaire. Plaire will become déplaire. Ranger, déranger. Okay, so ranger, déranger. And that's it. So keep in mind that, of course, it doesn't apply to all the verbs, because in some cases it's not possible to modify the original verbs, okay? But then, well, this is quite useful because, as you can see, it's not that difficult, and then you could use these verbs quite often, okay? If you want more videos, then youtube.com/imagier, and then like me on Facebook, facebook.com/imagier.net, and you can find a lot of things at the following address, www.imagier.net. Have a great day. Bye bye. Préfixe de verbe, and we'll focus this video on this préfixe de accent aigu s. Okay. So actually, I've been having many questions regarding, or from students regarding the translation of this un prefix in English. So like when you get do and undo, or this. Because it could be this as well for some verbs. And we saw in the previous lesson that the first prefix that we should use is de. Okay, it was in the lesson, so unit 12, lesson C. Okay, but then this prefix will be used for the verbs that will start with a consonant. Okay, but then we've got also verbs starting with a vowel, or then the mute H plus a vowel, and then in that case we'll have to use de accent aigu S. Okay, so in this video we'll see this de accent aigu S. Okay, and it will be used for, so the verb starting with a vowel, or then H, so H, but then muet, mute, okay, plus a vowel. So remember that we're not talking about all the verbs starting with H. And then we'll have also the option of DES, so you can see that you don't have any accent here, and it will be used only for the verbs that will start with the letter S here, okay? So keep in mind, DE accent aigu S will be used for verbs starting with whether une voyelle or H muet, okay, and then D, E without the accent, S will be used for the verbs starting with S. Okay, so let's see now a few examples. The first one, s'abonner, s'abonner, se désabonner, s'abonner, se désabonner. Armée, armée. Désarmée, désarmée. Okay, so armée will give you this désarmée. Avantagé, avantagé will give you désavantagé, désavantagé. Équilibré, Équilibré will give you déséquilibré. Déséquilibré. Okay, déséquilibré, sorry. Déséquilibré. Espérer. Espérer. Désespéré. Désespéré. Okay, espérer. Désespéré. Habillé. Habillé. Déshabillé. Déshabillé. Okay, so you can see that here, this H here, this letter is not pronounced. So, habillé and then déshabillé. Intéressé. Intéressé. Désintéressé. Désintéressé. Obéir. Obéir. Désobéir. Désobéir. Organiser. Organiser. Désorganiser. Désorganiser. We'll start a series of videos that will cover the subject, les préfixes et les verbes. And this, in this video, we will see actually the verb dire. You get the translation here in English. So dire, okay. And then we'll see that it's possible to add some prefixes. So it's possible to add some letters before this dire. And then by adding these letters, we will modify the meaning of dire. Okay, so let's see. And the first thing that we've got here is contre and then dire. Okay, contredire, contredire, and you can see that of course the meaning is changing. Contredire, okay, then interdire, interdire, prédire. Prédire, redire, redire. Les préfixes et les verbes. So this video will only focus on the verb mener. Okay, this is the meaning of mener. Okay, and we'll see that by adding few letters in front of mener, we will actually change the meaning of this verb. So the original meaning of this verb, and this is right here, the original meaning. Okay, so let's see now. The first one is amener. Amener. Okay, and you can see here the translation. Then emmener. Emmener. Okay, same thing here. Ramener. Ramener. Surmener. Surmener. And then you've got a translation right here. Les préfixes et les verbes. And in this video, we'll see the verb lever. Okay, so this is the translation in English of lever. And then we'll see that by adding few letters in front of lever, we'll actually change the meaning of this verb. Okay, so, and the first one would be enlever. Enlever. Relever, relever, soulever, soulever. Les préfixes et les verbes, and we'll see in this video the verb mettre. Okay, so that's the translation of mettre. Okay, mettre. And so we'll see that when we add few letters in front of mettre, well, in this case, actually, it will change the meaning, the original meaning of this verb. Okay, so the first one will be admettre. Okay, so admettre. And this is the translation in English. Admettre. Then we'll have commettre. Commettre. Then émettre. Émettre. And you get a translation here. Permettre. Permettre. Promettre. promettre. Remettre. Remettre. Soumettre. Soumettre. Transmettre. Transmettre. And you've got a translation right here. Les préfixes et les verbes. And in this video, we'll concentrate on the verb paraître. So this is the meaning of paraître. And the idea is that, of course, when we're talking about les préfixes, we will add few letters in front of paraître. And by adding these letters, we'll change the meaning of the verb. Okay, so let's see. The first one will be apparaître. Apparaître. And you've got here the translation in English. Disparaître. Disparaître. Reparaître. Reparaître. And you've got the translation right here. Les préfixes et les verbes, okay? So, and in this video, we'll concentrate on the verb passer. And here you have the translation in English. Okay, so the idea is that we've got this verb passer, and then it will be possible to add some letters, so that's what we call préfix, in front of passer. And by adding these letters, well, we'll change the meaning, the original meaning of the verb passer. Okay, so let's see how it goes. So the first thing, if we add this D, okay, we will get the verb dépasser, dépasser, and here you have the meaning in English. Okay, well, then we could add this re in front of passer, so we get this repasser, and then here is the meaning in English, repasser. Okay, and it's also possible to add sur, okay, surpasser, surpasser, and here is the meaning in English. Les préfixes et les verbes, okay, and in this video we'll focus on the verb porter, and that's how it could be translated. Okay, so the idea is that we will add some letters before, and then by adding these letters, the meaning, the original meaning of the verb will be modified. Okay, so let's see now. The first one, so if you add this AP, AP, you will get apporter, apporter. Okay, that's actually a translation of this verb, apporter. Okay, then we can add COM, so comporter, 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 okay, and that's the translation here. Or it could be se comporter, okay, se comporter. And you have here the meaning of this verb. Then it's possible to add EM, so you will get the emporter, okay, emporter. And here is the translation. X, X, exporter, exporter. Well, this one is actually quite easy to translate, okay? Exporter. Then it's possible to use this IM in front, so importer, importer. Okay, you can hear the translations. Then it's possible to use this RAP, so rap, rapporter, rapporter. And also it's possible to use this REM, rend, remporter, okay, remporter, remporter. You can also add this SUP in front of porter, sup, supporter, supporter. You don't really pronounce the two or the double P here, supporter. Or then it's possible to use this or to add this T-R-A-N-S, trans, transporter, Transporter. Transporter. You can also use this RAP. Rap. Rapporter. Rapporter. So same thing here, you don't pronounce the double P. Rapporter. Les préfixes et les verbes, and in that video, we'll actually have poser. And so you've got the translations here. Okay, of poser. And so remember that, well, the idea is that we will add letters in front of poser, so that's what we call préfix. And by adding these préfix, we will modify the meaning or the original meaning of the verb poser. Okay, so let's see now what we've got. So it's possible to add this com prefix, con, composer. Okay, composer. All right, and you've got here the translations of this verb. Composer. It's also possible to add the prefix de, accent aigu, de. Dé, and you get déposer, all right, déposer, and here you can find what it means in English, okay, déposer. It's also possible to add the prefix entre, 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 and you get entreposer, 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 okay, and here is the meaning. That it's possible to add this PRO, pro, proposer, okay, proposer. Or then you can also add this RE, re, reposer, 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 okay, and here you've got the translation. It's also possible to have, when we're talking about this reposer, well, this se reposer, se reposer, se reposer. Les préfixes et les verbes. And in this video, we'll actually focus on the verb prendre. Here is, or here are the translations possible for prendre, okay, and the idea is that, of course, we're talking about prefix, so these letters that you can add before the verb, and by adding this these letters, you will modify the original meaning of the verb. Okay, so let's see a few examples now. The first one, AP, so app, you will get apprendre, apprendre, okay, you don't pronounce the double P, apprendre, so here is what it means. Okay, apprendre. Then it's possible to put this com in front of prendre, and you will get comprendre, comprendre. Okay, comprendre. It's also possible to use this entre, entre, entreprendre, entreprendre, entreprendre. It's also possible to use this RE, re, reprendre, reprendre, reprendre. Okay, get translation here. SUR, 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 surprendre. Okay, surprendre. And here is what it means. Okay, surprendre. Les préfixes et les verbes, and in this lesson, we'll concentrate on the verb tenir. And here is how you could translate this verb in English. Okay? So the idea is that it will be possible to add what we call prefix, so actually letters before this verb, and by adding these letters, you will modify the meaning, the original meaning of this verb. Okay, so let's see now a few examples. So the first one that we have, if you add the letters C-O-N, con, you will get contenir, contenir, contenir. Okay, and that's how it could be translated. Then it's possible to add this entre, entre, and you will get entretenir, entretenir, entretenir. And here is the meaning. Okay, then it's also possible to add this m-a-i-n, main, maintenir, maintenir. Okay, and that's how you should, or you could translate it. It's also possible to use this re prefix, re, retenir, retenir, and that's what it means. And also sou, sous, soutenir, soutenir, okay, soutenir. Les préfixes et les verbes, and the last verb that we will see together is venir. Okay, so you get the translation here. Okay, so venir, and then when we talk about les préfixes, well, we will talk about letters that we will add in front of venir, and by adding these letters, we'll change the meaning or the original meaning of this verb. Okay, so let's see how it will go. The first thing that we could add would be con, con, and then we would get convenir. Convenir, okay, and here you will see for each verb the translation in English. Okay, convenir. We also have the possibility to add d and e, de, devenir, okay, devenir. It's also possible to add this inter, inter, inter. Intervenir, intervenir, intervenir. And then we can also add PRE accent aigu, pré, prévenir, prévenir, prévenir. Okay. We can add also this re, re, revenir, revenir, revenir. And so it's possible to add this sou, sous, okay, and the verb is réflexif, réfléchi, sorry, se souvenir, se souvenir, se souvenir. It's also possible to add this sub, 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 subvenir, subvenir, subvenir. And the last one, sur, sur. Survenir, survenir, survenir. Identical words in English and in French, and we'll concentrate on the words that ends with age in English. And the first thing that, well, we should definitely keep in mind is that they will be the same, but if they exist in French, because it's not the case all the time, okay? So we've got few exceptions. We will have few modifications possible in French, of course. And the thing that you should keep in mind, that in most of the cases, but not all the cases, we'll see that in this video, they will be masculine in French, okay? So that's one easy thing to remember, of course exceptions, but if you're not sure, then put the masculine form. In most of the cases, that will be the correct form. Okay, so let's see them now. Un avantage, un âge, un arbitrage, un assemblage, un bagage, Un bandage. Un barrage. Un blocage. Un brassage. Un bricolage. Une cage. So this is one of the exceptions. It's feminine. Un camouflage. Un carnage. Un cartilage. Un chantage. Un collage. Un concubinage. Un cordage. Un corsage. Un courage. Un cousinage. Un découpage. Un dressage. Un entourage. Un équipage. Un espionnage. Un forage. Un fuselage. Un gage. Un garage. Un héritage. Une image. Keep in mind, feminine. Un langage. Un lavage. Un maquillage. Un mariage. Un massage. Un ménage. Un message. Une page. Feminine as well. Un passage. Un pelage. Une plage. Feminine. Une rage. Feminine as well. Un ravage. Un remariage. Un rivage. Un sabotage. Un usage. Un visage. Almost identical words in English and in French. And we're talking about the words that will end in English with IC, like that. And in French, that's the reason why they are almost identical. They will end with IQUE. Phonetically, it will be exactly the same. So IC, IC, okay, but then we write it like that. Keep in mind that the first rule is that it must, of course, exist in French, and it's not all the time the case. And then in some cases, we will have few exceptions or modifications possible. Okay, so let's start. Académique, acoustique, acrobatique, angélique, aérodynamique, aéronautique, allergique, analogique, anarchique, antinomique, athlétique, antiseptique, arctique, argotique, aristocratique, arithmétique, aromatique, artistique, asthmatique, astronomique, athlétique, atmosphérique, atomique, atypique, automatique, basique, bureaucratique, catholique, céramique, chaotique, caractéristique, charismatique, civique, classique, climatique, clinique, comique, cosmétique, cosmique, cubique, démagogique, démocratique, démographique, dermatologique, désertique, diabolique, diagnostique, diamétrique, didactique, dramatique, dramaturgique, dynamique, dynastique, écologique, économique, égocentrique, électrique, électronique, emblématique, empirique, encyclopédique, énigmatique, épidémique, épisodique, esthétique, éthique, ethnique, euphorique, évangélique, exotique, fabrique, fanatique, fantastique, fatidique, folklorique, frénétique, gastronomique, générique, génétique, géographique. Almost identical words in English and in French, and we are talking about the words in English that will end with IC like that, and in French that's the reason why I said it was almost, because it's not totally identical, because we've got in French it will be with IQUE. Phonetically it's the same, IC, IC, okay, but we will write it like that. The first thing you should keep in mind is that of course the word must exist in French, and it's not the case all the time. And then, of course, we will have few exceptions or modifications possible. You will see that when I will read the words. Okay, so let's start now. Géologique, géométrique, gothique, graphique, gymnastique, héroïque, hiérarchique, historique, homéopathique, humoristique, hydraulique, hygiénique, hypnotique, idéologique, idiomatique, idyllique, illogique, inorganique, ironique, italique, journalistique, juridique, lactique, linguistique, lithographique, logique, logistique, lyrique, magique, magnétique, magnifique, maléfique, mathématique, mécanique, mélodique, méthodique, mimique, minéralogique, musique, narcotique, neurologique, nordique, nostalgique, numérique, océanique, océanographique, oligarchique, ophtalmologique, optique, organique, orthopédique, panique, parodique, pédagogique, pédiatrique, philharmonique, philosophique, phonétique, photogénique, photographique, physique, plastique, platonique, poétique, polémique, politique, pragmatique, problématique, prolifique, psychiatrique, psychologique, public, pudique, république, romantique, rubrique, scientifique, sociologique, statistique, symbolique, tactique, technique, technologique, téléphonique, thermique, touristique, toxique, toxicologique, tragique, tropique, typique, véridique, vocalique, volcanique, volcanologique, zoologique, zygomatique. Identical words in English and in French. Sorry, I was somewhere else. And we'll talk in this lesson about the words ending in English with a, de, e. Okay? And of course, the first thing that we've got to keep in mind is, well, the word must exist in French, which is not the case for all the words ending with ad. Okay, so that's the first thing. But then if they do exist, well, the meaning will be the same. Keep also in mind that we've got, of course, few exceptions or few modifications possible. And in most of the cases, but not all the cases, we'll see that they will be feminine. Okay, so we can start right now. Oops. Une accolade, une arcade, une balade, une balustrade, une barricade, une brigade, une cascade, une charade, une chiffonnade, une escalade, une escapade, une esplanade, une façade, une fusillade, une grenade, une grillade, une noyade, une orangeade, une palissade, une parade, une passade, un plantigrade. You've got an exception here. Une promenade. Un or une rétrograde. Une sérénade. Un stade. Exception. Une tirade. Une torsade. Identical words in English and in French, and especially the words that will end with in English, well, actually, they will be written the same way in French, and the meaning will be the same, but the first rule that we've got to keep in mind is that, well, the word must exist in French, and it's not the case for all the words in English. Okay, and then the other thing, well, few exceptions, of course, or modifications possible. We're talking about accents or about modification of letters, not that big, but still they can occur. And then the second thing is that in most of the cases, but not all the cases, we'll see that they will be feminine. Okay, so let's see them now. Une altitude, une amplitude, une aptitude, une attitude, une béatitude, une certitude, une décrépitude, une étude, une exactitude, une gratitude, une habitude, une inaptitude, une incertitude, une inexactitude, une ingratitude, une inquiétude, un interlude, so exception here, une lassitude, une latitude, une longitude, une multitude, une platitude, une plénitude, un prélude, second exception, une promptitude, une quiétude, une rectitude, rude, une servitude, une solitude. Identical words in English and in French, and we're talking about the words ending with U-R-E. So the good news is that they will be exactly the same, or almost, as usual when we're talking about French language. But the first thing that we've got to keep in mind is that, of course, the word must exist in French. It's not the case for all the words in English ending with U-R-E, okay? And then, of course, keep in mind that we'll have few exceptions or modifications possible. We're talking about accents and different letters that could change, okay? But Then let's see how it goes. Une agriculture. Une allure. Une apiculture. Une aquaculture. Une arboriculture. Une architecture. Une armature. Une armure. Une aviculture. Une bordure. Une brochure, une candidature, une capture, une caricature, une ceinture, une censure, une chaussure, une chevelure, une clôture, une coiffure, une confiture. Une couture, une créature, une culture, une cure, une doublure, une facture, une figure, une fracture, une injure, une lecture, une manufacture, mature. Une miniature, une nature, un or une pédicure, une posture, une procédure, pure, une rupture, une sculpture, une sépulture, une signature, une structure. Une température, une texture, une torture, une viniculture, une viticulture.
Identical words in English and in French, and we'll concentrate this video on the words in English that will end with I-B-L-E, because actually they will be written almost the same way. I mean, in most of the cases, they will be written the same way, but not in all the cases, of course. And the meaning will be the same, all right? But then the first thing that you've got to keep in mind is that the word must exist in French, because all the words ending with I-B-L-E in English, well, they don't exist in French, okay? And then the second thing, as I said, in some cases, few exceptions or modifications when it comes to writing and, of course, pronunciation. Okay, so we'll see that together and we'll start right now. Accessible. Admissible. Audible. Bible. Combustible, comestible, compatible, compréhensible, conductible, constructible, convertible, corruptible. Crédible, divisible, éligible, extensible, flexible, fusible, horrible, impassible, implausible. Impossible, inaccessible, inadmissible, inaudible, it went away, incombustible, incompatible, incompréhensible, inconvertible. Incorrigible. incorruptible, indestructible, indivisible, inéligible, inflexible, intelligible, invincible, invisible, irrésistible, passible, possible, reconstructible, répréhensible, réversible, risible, sensible, terrible, transmissible, visible.
Identical words in English and in French, and especially the words that will end with A-B-L-E. Okay, so if we're talking about the words ending with A-B-L-E, you've got to remember that first it must exist in French. If it exists in French, then the meaning will be the same. Okay, and the second thing you should think about is that in some cases we will have, when it comes to the writing of the word, few exceptions or modifications possible. Okay, so let's start now. Abominable, absorbable, acceptable, adaptable, administrable, admirable, adoptable, adorable, applicable, appréciable, arbitrable, assimilable, attachable, biodégradable, blâmable, câble, calculable, capable, cartable, censurable, certifiable, changeable, chargeable, classifiable, confortable, commandable, comparable, confessable, confirmable, contestable, cultivable, défendable, déformable, dégradable, déplorable, détachable, détectable, durable, estimable, évitable, évitable, excusable, fable, favorable, filmable, fixable, formable, formidable, friable, groupable, habitable, héritable, honorable, identifiable, imitable, impalpable, implacable, importable, improbable, incapable, inclinable, incommunicable, incomparable, incontestable, indispensable, inflammable, inhabitable, inimitable, inséparable, instable, interminable, intolérable, invariable, invulnérable, lamentable, limitable, manipulable, mémorable, mimable, misérable, notable, palpable, payable, portable, qualifiable, quantifiable, recyclable, rentable, représentable, sociable, solvable, sortable, stable, table,
tenable, tolérable, transportable, transposable, véritable.
La place de l'adverbe. And we will focus on this video when we've got what we call une forme composée de verbe. So if you're thinking about, for instance, passé composé, all these composed tenses where you've got two parts, remember, first you've got avoir or être, and then the second part is le participe passé. Okay, so we'll see where we should put the adverb, l'adverbe, when we've got this type of structure. Okay, so we'll see only one sentence and we'll see the different possibilities we've got. So where to put this adverb, okay? So the first one, here, we've got il a attendu patiemment le train, okay? So here we've got the verb attendre. Attendre is to wait, and this is the passé composé form, if you remember. So first you've got avoir at the present tense, and then this form is what we call participe passé, okay? So il a attendu. And then, I mean, that's the rule. Normally, the adverb, l'adverbe, should come after the verb. Okay, so you put it right here. Patiemment, patiently, okay? And then le train, the train. Il a attendu patiemment le train. All right? So that's, I mean, the first option you could have if you want to construct this type of structure in which you will have this adverb. Okay, and then if you've got this structure, like here, when you've got a composed tense, so two parts. Okay, but then the same sentence, and it's also possible, il a, okay, so first you will put avoir, so you don't change the structure of the sentence, but then it's possible to put your adverb right here after avoir. Il a patiemment, and then you continue, here your participe passé, attendu le train. Okay, so the first one, il a attendu patiemment le train, and then the second one, il a patiemment attendu le train. Alright, and then we've got a third option, so it would be also possible to put it like that, il a attendu le train, and then you put your adverb at the end here, patiemment. Okay, oops, sorry, there is a space here and shouldn't be here. So, il a attendu le train patiemment. Okay, so let's see again the three options we've got. The first one, il a attendu patiemment le train. Second one, il a patiemment attendu le train. And the last one, il a attendu le train patiemment. Les locutions adverbiales. And we'll focus this video on les locutions adverbiales, when they will replace or when they will be associated with an adverb that will end with ment, M-E-N-T. Okay, so let's see now an example. So, of course, when we're talking about adverbs, like here, we're talking about, well, this word that you can add to the verb to give more information, like il parle gentiment. Okay, you've got here the verb parler. Parler is to speak or to talk. And then gentiment, nicely. Okay, donc il parle gentiment. So that's the first option. I mean, you can add this adverb after your verb just to give more information. Okay, or then it would be possible also to use what we call locution adverbiale. Okay, to, well, clearly get exactly the same meaning, but in that case here, you will use, well, une locution, so a group of words, okay, and then these words are not adverbs, but then they will have the same function and the result will be the same. Il parle avec, so avec, with, and then gentillesse, kindness, avec gentillesse. Il parle avec gentillesse. So this avec gentillesse, this is exactly what we call locution adverbiale. Okay, so we'll see a few examples now, and the first one will be prudemment, prudemment, okay, so you get the translation here, prudemment, okay, and then you could use une locution adverbiale avec prudence, okay, so you can use prudemment, or then you can use avec prudence. All right? Patiemment. Patiemment. Get a translation here. Or then you could use avec patience. Okay? Patiemment avec patience. Calmement. Calmement. Or then avec calme. Okay? So whether calmement or then avec calme. Péniblement. Péniblement. Translation here. Or then you could use avec peine. Avec peine. All right? So whether péniblement or la locution adverbiale, sorry, avec peine. Merveilleusement. It's a long one. Merveilleusement. Merveilleusement. Okay, you've got a translation here. Or then you could use à merveille. All right, so whether merveilleusement or à merveille. Effectivement. Effectivement. Or then, en effet. En effet. Okay, so effectivement, en effet. Généralement. 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 Or then, en général. Généralement or en général. Particulièrement. Particulièrement. Particulièrement or en particulier. En particulier. Particulièrement. En particulier. Partiellement. Partiellement. Or then, en partie. Okay? Partiellement. En partie. Silencieusement. 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 Or then you could use en silence. Silencieusement. En silence. Progressivement. 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 Or then you could use whether petit à petit or peu à peu. Okay, so progressivement or petit à petit ou peu à peu. Les locutions adverbiales. So when we talk about les locutions adverbiales, we will talk about group of words that will together, when you put them together, you can use them instead of an adverb. Okay, so it can be quite useful. And we'll see a list of locutions adverbiales in this video. Okay, so the first one would be à juste titre. À juste titre. Okay, and you'll find below the translation in English. À juste titre. À tort. À tort. À tort. À volonté. À volonté. À volonté. Oops, sorry. À l'écart. À l'écart. À l'écart. À l'endroit. À l'endroit. À l'endroit. And then, à l'envers. À l'envers. À l'envers. À l'unanimité. À l'unanimité. It's a tricky one, this one. Unanimité. À l'unanimité. À l'unanimité. Du coup. Du coup. Du coup. Du coup. en fait. So whether you pronounce the final T or not, you can hear both. En fait, en fait, en fait. I'd rather pronounce it personally. En fait. En réalité. En réalité. En réalité. En vrac. En vrac. En vrac. Par cœur. Par cœur. Par cœur. Les antonymes, okay, or then we can use as well les contraires. And we'll see only les antonymes or les contraires that will be constructed with les préfixes D or DE accent aigu S. Okay, so but then, well, then the first thing that maybe we should define or clear out is what an antonyme or un contraire is. And well, in English, it's almost the same, okay, or then contraire, it's opposite. Okay, so we'll see these antonyme or contraire constructed with D or DE accent aigu S. And we'll first start with the DE accent aigu. And so, the first one, favorable. Okay, so I will put all the time in green here, the translation in English. Favorable, and it will give us défavorable. Alright, so, favorable, défavorable. Favoriser, favoriser. Same technique, you just put this D. Défavoriser. Okay, favoriser, défavoriser. Pénaliser, pénaliser. Will give us dépénaliser. Okay, so pénaliser, dépénaliser. And then obviously the substantive as well, pénalisation. Pénalisation will give us dépénalisation. Okay, pénalisation, and then just dépénalisation. And now we'll see the other group, so DE accent aigu S. Okay, so you get to keep in mind that, of course, we will put this S because, well, the words will start with whether a vowel or the sound of a vowel. That's normally the reason why we put this S like that when we're talking about this prefix. Okay, so first one, agréable, agréable, and then it will give us désagréable. Okay, agréable, and then désagréable. Espérer, so it's the verb here, espérer, and then it will give us désespérer, désespérer. Okay, so espérer, and then désespérer. Substantive, espoir, espoir. Exactly the same way of constructing or constructing the thing. So désespoir, espoir, désespoir. Obéir, okay, the verb obéir, and then we'll get désobéir. All right, so obéir and désobéir. Obéissance, obéissance will give us désobéissance, désobéissance. Okay, so obéissance and then désobéissance. Organiser, it's the verb organiser, and it will give us désorganiser, désorganiser. Okay, so organiser and then désorganiser. And then naturally, organisation, organisation will give us désorganisation. Okay, désorganisation, organisation, désorganisation. Les antonymes, or then it's also possible to call them les contraires.
Okay, and we'll see especially les antonymes, au contraire, that will start with a prefix mal or me. Okay, so first thing that we should see together is what is an antonym or un contraire. Well, in English, it would be translated by antonym or opposite. Okay, and so we'll see in this lesson first the antonym that will start with mal, and then after that we'll see the ones that will start with me. Okay, so let's concentrate first on the mal. And so, first example, quite interesting, and it's heureux here. Okay, so you can see the translation in English here in green. Heureux, okay, and so if you want to make the opposite, le contraire, l'antonyme, then you just put this mal and then heureux. Malheureux. Alright, so heureux will give you malheureux. Alright, second example. Honnête. Honnête. And then exactly the same rule. So malhonnête. Malhonnête. So honnête. Malhonnête. Habile. Habile will give you malhabile. Malhabile. Okay, so habile, and then you just put this mal, malhabile. Adroit, adroit will give you maladroit. Okay, so quite simple, adroit, and then maladroit. So now let's see the one that will start with me. Okay, and the first one is content. Okay, so I did put the feminine form here, like that. So, content, masculine form. Of course, if you put the feminine form, then you will have to add this e, and then phonetically it will be a bit different. It will be contente. Okay, so masculin, content. Féminin, contente. Alright, and then if you want to put the opposite, or construct the opposite, so you will get this mécontent. And then the feminine form, mécontente. Okay, so content, mécontent, and then the feminine, contente, mécontente. Alright. Connu, so exactly the same thing. I did put the feminine form here, but then phonetically it doesn't exist. You don't pronounce it, so it will be the same form phonetically for the masculine form and the feminine form. Connu. Okay, so connu. And then it will give you méconnu. Okay? Connu, méconnu. Le verbe faire. Le verbe faire is used quite much in French language. And then I thought it might be useful to make a little lesson regarding the verb faire and the different uses we've got for this verb. And of course, so I can show you the example, we'll have the translation. Okay, so faire here, and then we've got an example here, faire un gâteau, it's a cake. Okay, and in that case, of course, if you want to translate that, well, you could use this to make. Okay, and then faire un dessin, a drawing, faire un dessin, in that case, that's, it would be translated with to do. Okay, so these are of course the two first translations that normally we tend to use when we translate the verb faire. Okay, but then we'll see that we've got other uses of faire. For instance, faire du piano. Okay, and in that case, well, clearly you would translate it with to play. Okay, faire du piano. Then it could be as well faire du football, so basket, whatever. So we're talking here about sport activity, and in that case it will be also to play. Okay, faire les magasins. Okay, magasin, we're talking about boutique, so shops. And in that case it would be to go shopping. Okay, so faire un gâteau, faire un dessin, faire du piano, faire du foot. Faire les magasins. Okay, let's see some other uses. Here, faire le mort. Okay, to play dead. Faire le mort, so it could be faire le fou, faire something. So actually, you pretend to be something that you're not. Okay, so in that case, faire le mort, to play dead. Faire 10 euros. It's quite interesting because we tend to use that quite often as well when you're talking about the price, so the how much it will cost. Okay, so ça fait 10 euros. Okay, in that case, translation would be to cost. It's also possible to use this faire when you're talking about the weight. So, faire 300 grammes. Or then, it's also possible if you want to talk about your size. So, in that case, when you say faire 1m80, of course, you're talking about your size, so to be tall. And then faire du diabète, so you can see that it's also possible to use it when we're talking about medical things. And then so it would be, in that case, to have, of course. Ne rien faire, and especially this sentence, it's, well, it's quite common to use this, ça ne fait rien, okay? And the translation would be, it doesn't matter, okay? So, ça ne fait rien, ça ne fait rien. Other little modification, ça ne me fait rien, okay, so ça ne me fait rien, in that case it's for me, and well, translation would be, I don't mind, okay, so ça ne fait rien, it doesn't matter, but then ça ne me fait rien, I don't mind, okay, then faire quelque chose, in that case it would be to act, alright, faire jeune. So when you use this expression, il fait jeune, you're talking about the appearance, so it would be to look, okay, to look young, faire jeune. Faire bien, ça fait bien, and the translation would be to look as well, so it looks good, okay. The last page, but not the least interesting. So, il fait chaud, so you can see that we tend to use this faire when we're talking about, well, the weather or the temperature, so in that case, it's hot. And then, il fait froid, so obviously, it's cold. And we've got this expression that we tend to use quite often, il fait beau, okay? And then the translation will be, it's a nice weather or it's a lovely day, il fait beau. Okay, you can put that, of course, at the negative form as well. Or then, ça fait 3 ans que. And in that case, the translation will be, it's been 3 years since. Okay, ça fait 3 ans que. Well, then we can take another example. It would be a slightly different. Ça fait 2 ans que j'apprends le français. So the translation would be, I have been learning French for 2 years. Les locutions adverbiales qui expriment le temps. Okay, so first thing, of course, is what are we talking about when we're talking about une locution adverbiale. Okay, well, actually, it's quite simple because if we're talking about une locution adverbiale, so we'll talk about a group of words that will together replace an adverb. Okay, so it's an option that you will have to complete a verb, because that's the first function of what we call an adverb, okay? But then you don't have to use this adverb if it exists or if it doesn't exist. And still, in that case, you will use this locution adverbiale, so group of words that will be used instead of an adverb, okay? So to complete a verb. So we'll see them right now. À l'instant, okay, and then for each locution adverbiale, I will give you the translation in English right here, okay? So, à l'instant, à la longue, à présent, à l'avenir, à l'avenir, avec le temps, avec le temps, pour l'instant, pour l'instant. En ce moment, pour le moment,
le moment, pour le moment. De bonne heure, de bonne heure, de bonne heure. Tôt, tôt, tôt. Tard, tard, tard. D'un moment à l'autre, d'un moment à l'autre, d'un moment à l'autre. En avance, en avance, en avance. À l'heure, à l'heure, à l'heure. En retard, en retard, en retard. Sur le champ, sur le champ, sur le champ. Tout de suite, tout de suite. Tout de suite.
Or then it's also possible to pronounce it like tout de suite.
Tout de suite. Tout à l'heure. Tout à l'heure. Tout à l'heure.
For the locution adverbiale. And then qui exprime la rapidité. And of course, the first thing that we've got to well understand is what is une locution adverbiale. And well, the answer is quite simple. When we're talking about une locution adverbiale, we're talking about a group of words that all together will be used instead of what we call an adverb, okay? So remember, when we're talking about an adverb, it's this type of words that we will use normally to complete a verb, so to give more information with a verb. And then in that case, in most of the cases, we tend to use an adverb, but then it's also possible to use group of words that will all together have the same use and the same function of like an adverb. Okay, so we'll see them together right now. The first one, à toute vitesse. Okay, and you will see here the translation in English. Okay, à toute vitesse. À toute vitesse. À toute vitesse. À toute allure. À toute allure. À toute allure. En un clin d'œil. En un clin d'œil. En un clin d'œil. En un rien de temps. En un rien de temps. En un rien de temps. En toute hâte, en toute hâte, en toute hâte. Les locutions adverbiales qui expriment la situation géographique. Okay, but then the first thing that we've got to see is, of course, what are we talking when we are talking about une locution adverbiale? And actually, it's quite simple because une locution adverbiale, well, it's a group of words that all together will be used as an adverb, okay? So that's exactly what we will use une locution adverbiale for, okay? So it's just a complete verb, all right? And then you're using it instead of an adverb just because, well, you want to use something else if the adverb is existing, or then in some cases, well, adverbs are not existing to express what la locution adverbiale will express. Okay, so we'll see now the first one. au-dessus. Au-dessus. Okay, so each time you will see the translation in English below. Au-dessus. Au-dessous. 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 En dessous. En dessous. En dessous. En face. En face. En face. Par-dessus. 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 Par-dessous. 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 Sans dessus-dessous. Sans dessus dessous. Sans dessus-dessous. Le repas. Okay, so let's start now. Un potage. Un potage. Un potage. Une soupe. Une soupe. Une soupe. Un bouillon. Un bouillon. Un bouillon. Un rôti. Un rôti. Un rôti. Un ragoût. Un ragoût. Un ragoût. Un soufflet. Un soufflet. Un soufflet. Une quiche. Une quiche. Une quiche. Un shish kebab. Or un kebab. Un kebab. Un kebab. Or then, un shish kebab. Un shish kebab. Une boulette de viande. Une boulette de viande. Une boulette de viande. Une omelette. Une omelette. Une omelette. Un sauté. Un sauté. Un sauté. Une salade verte. Une salade verte. Une salade verte. Une salade composée. Une salade composée. Une salade composée. Des pâtes. Des pâtes. Des pâtes. Du riz. Du riz. Du riz. Une vinaigrette. Une vinaigrette. Une vinaigrette. Une entrée. Une entrée. Une entrée. Un plat principal. Un plat principal. Un plat principal. Un accompagnement. Un accompagnement. Un accompagnement. Un fromage.
un fromage, un fromage. Un dessert, un dessert, un dessert.
Les produits laitiers. Okay, we've got a translation here in English. So, les produits laitiers, let's start right now.
Un lait entier. Un lait entier. Un lait entier. Un lait demi-écrémé. Un lait demi-écrémé. Un lait demi-écrémé. Un lait écrémé. Un lait écrémé. Un lait écrémé. Un beurre. Un beurre. Un beurre. Une margarine. Une margarine.
Sorry. Une margarine. Well, this one was not too difficult anyway.
Une crème. Une crème. Une crème. Une crème allégée. Une crème allégée. Une crème allégée. Une crème épaisse. Une crème épaisse. Une crème épaisse. Une crème fouettée. Une crème fouettée. Une crème fouettée. Une crème fraîche. Une crème fraîche. Une crème fraîche. Un yaourt.
Oups,
un yaourt, un yaourt. Une glace. Une glace, une glace. Un fromage. Un fromage, un fromage. Un fromage à pâte molle. Un fromage à pâte molle. Un fromage à pâte molle.
Oups.
My God. Un fromage à pâte semi-molle. Un fromage à pâte semi-molle. Un fromage à pâte semi-molle. Un fromage à pâte pressée non cuite. Un fromage à pâte pressée non cuite. Un fromage à pâte pressée non cuite. Un fromage à pâte pressée cuite. Un fromage à pâte pressée cuite. Un fromage à pâte pressée cuite. Un fromage à la crème. Un fromage à la crème. Un fromage à la crème. Un fromage frais. Un fromage frais. Un fromage frais. Un fromage râpé. Un fromage râpé. Un fromage râpé. Les œufs.
So it will be a short one, but I think it's quite useful in some cases to only focus on the little thing, okay? So after that everything is clear. The first one that we'll see is un œuf.
Un œuf, un œuf.
And the tricky thing when we're talking about eggs is that if you listen carefully, the pronunciation is changing quite much, because for the singular form it's œuf, but then for the plural form here it's œufs, okay? Des œufs. Des œufs, des œufs. Un œuf de poule. Un œuf de poule. Un œuf de poule. Un œuf de canne. Un œuf de canne. Un œuf de canne. Un œuf de caille. Un œuf de caille. Un œuf de caille. Un œuf d'oie. Un œuf d'oie. Un œuf d'oie. Une coquille. Une coquille. Une coquille. Le blanc d'œuf. Le blanc d'œuf. Le blanc d'œuf. Le jaune d'œuf. Le jaune d'œuf. Le jaune d'œuf. Les herbes. Okay, so let's start now. Le fenouil. Le fenouil. Le fenouil. La feuille de laurier. La feuille de laurier. La feuille de laurier. Le persil. In some cases you can hear persil, okay, but normally it should be le persil. Le persil. Le persil. La ciboulette. La ciboulette. La ciboulette. La menthe. La menthe. La menthe. Le thym. Le thym. Le thym. La sauge. La sauge. La sauge. L'estragon. L'estragon. La marjolaine. La marjolaine. La marjolaine. Le basilic. Le basilic. Le basilic. L'origan. L'origan. La coriandre. La coriandre. La coriandre. L'aneth. L'aneth. Le romarin. Le romarin. Le romarin. Les haricots et les pois. Okay, so you get the translation in English right here. Let's start now. Un haricot vert. Un haricot vert. Un haricot vert. Un haricot grimpant. Un haricot grimpant. Sorry. Un haricot grimpant. Une fève. Une fève. Une fève. Un gros haricot blanc.
Un gros haricot blanc. Un gros haricot blanc. Un haricot blanc. Un haricot blanc. Un haricot blanc. Un haricot rouge. Un haricot rouge. Un haricot rouge. Une graine de soja. Une graine de soja. Une graine de soja. Un haricot à œil noir. Un haricot à œil noir. Un haricot à œil noir. Un flageolet. Un flageolet. Un flageolet. Une lentille. Une lentille. Une lentille. Une lentille rouge. Une lentille rouge. Une lentille rouge. Un pois chiche. Un pois chiche. Un pois chiche. Un pois cassé. Un pois cassé. Un pois cassé. Les poissons. So quite useful one. Une lotte. Une lotte. Une lotte. Un maquereau. Un maquereau. Un maquereau. Un espadon. Un espadon. Un espadon. Une sole. Une sole. Une sole. Une limande sole. Une limande sole. Une limande sole. Un aigle fin. Un aigle fin. Un aigle fin. Une sardine. Une sardine. Une sardine. Une raie. Une raie. Une raie. Un merlan. Un merlan. Un merlan. Un bar. Un bar. Un bar. Un saumon. Un saumon. Un saumon. Une morue. Une morue. Une morue. Une dorade. Une dorade. Une dorade. Un thon. Un thon. Un thon. Un rouget barbet. Un rouget barbet. Un rouget barbet. Un flétan. Un flétan. Un flétan. Une truite arc-en-ciel. Une truite arc-en-ciel. Une truite arc-en-ciel.